Get ready to match the stars. Avery Shriver, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Wright, Ethel Merman, Richard Dawson, and Joyce Bulifant as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Rodder.
Such a star. Yes. Thank you, Johnny Olsen. And I look like a what?
An orange sherbet.
Hell, you know what you do with them.
Yeah,
yes, thank
yes,
you very much.
Hello. Hi, darling.
Hi.
I would like to do a Richard Dawson quote.
Yes?
Follow that man. There must be a carnival in town somewhere.
You didn't say that?
What did you say?
You must wear that. When I want to take you with me, we go to Chicago on the 26th of June to
yes.
see this lady in concert, Ethel Merman in concert.
Oh, yeah, where is she going to do that there?
I don't know the hall yet, but it's that hasn't been figured out. It'll be advertised.
26th of June. In Chicago.
In
my old hometown.
We'll be there clapping with
great
us.
City.
You go and see her. She's a nice lady.
Okay. That's okay. A sweet thing to do. Thank you very much. Now let's say hello to Murray Metz and Kathy Beardsley. Here they are. How are you?
I'm fine, thanks.
Good. Now, Murray has won $600, which brings a little joy to his heart, I hope.
It does, it does.
And he's being challenged by Kathy. We're in the middle of round one. She had her first question and apparently never heard of cow chips, did she? Or whatever they're called.
There.
And now we're going to give a round one question to you. Remember, they're a little tougher now, so get set for it. In the meantime, let's take a look at this. Ready? Here we go. Bing. All right. Remember, Murray, this is a toughie. Round one questions are toughies. John Wayne said, I don't do John Wayne. Do you do John Wayne?
No.
You do John Wayne?
I've had John Wayne.
You do John Wayne?
No.
No, no one did. Do you do John Wayne?
Oh, yes.
Well, that's all right.
That's
very
good.
Is that
good.
John Wayne?
Pretty
yeah.
good.
Yeah, try them.
I've fallen in love all over again.
You know, the only thing I like of love about John Wayne is the way he walks.
That looks more like Paul Lynn.
Is that?
You may not know this, stranger, but underneath all these rugged clothes, I'm wearing a blank.
You may not know this, stranger, but underneath all these rugged clothes, I'm wearing a blank.
Wait.
Okay. All right. Put it in the slot there.
Look, Charles is finished.
Charles is finished. Good. All right, let's get on with it. Come over here to Murray Metz. All lights are lighted, are they? They are indeed.
John, say, you may not know this, stranger, but underneath all these rugged clothes, I'm wearing a...
I hope he forgives me. He's wearing a bra.
A bra? He's this tall, you know.
I know.
He's twice as tall as you are, Murray.
I know.
How tall is he?
He's that tall.
He's that tall.
Yes, he's that tall there.
Well,
what do you
it
say?
Must be a very lanky bra.
A bra?
I didn't even
think of that answer. What do you say?
Well, I do know. I spoke earlier of my relationship with John Wayne. I don't want to go into it, but he doesn't need a bra. But I will tell you what he does have on, honey. He has a sweet little lace panty girdle.
That's what I thought. I don't know if there's lace on it. I just thought a girdle to hold himself together there. What'd you say?
I didn't go that route.
What?
Yeah.
You didn't go that route. What route did you...
What route did you go? Well, that's all right.
I said truss.
A truss. Well, you know he's been in the saddle for all those years.
Trust.
In John, we trust. You said that.
Oh.
wouldn't. What do you say, Ziz? Underneath all these rugged clothes, I'm wearing a...
I said he was wearing a size tall pantyhose.
A size tall pantyhose. John Wayne, you're so disillusioning to us all. Okay, Richard.
I said he was wearing a dress.
A dress? Are you all aware of the fact that he really is that tall?
Yeah, he got it at Tall Gal.
Yes, and you, Joyce.
Well, I say when he's doing those westerns and he gets shot and he falls down, it takes four men to carry him out. Two abreast. A bra.
Two abreast. Okay.
So there's our round one. At the end of round one, scores 2-0 favor the champ, and we immediately go to round two. Kathy, it's your choice.
I'll stay with B.
B, now you're a little wiser in your ways, aren't you?
I think so.
Okay, listen carefully. Dumb Donald was so dumb.
How dumb was he?
I'll tell you, he didn't have an air conditioner, so to keep cool, he stuck a blank down his pants. That's how dumb he was.
What?
Dumb Donald was so dumb, he didn't have an air conditioner, so to keep cool, he stuck a blank down his pants.
I don't know if I understand that question, huh?
He was dumb. To keep cool, he stuck a blank down his pants.
Dumb. Well, dumb is the operative word, right, sweetheart?
Yes, dumb is the operative word. Dumb Donald.
Now I'm trying to think of the perfect answer.
Right.
You will.
You're a card. You're a card. Leave that lady alone.
Oh, shut up.
I got music.
Shut up.
If I sound like that, I'm going to kill myself.
No, you don't sound like that. How many shows with Cole Porter did you do?
Five.
Five shows. What were they?
Let me see. Something for the Boys. Red Hot and Blue.
Right.
Panama Hattie.
Yeah.
DeBarry Was a Lady.
Oh, yeah.
And what was the last one?
What was the last one, Ira?
What was the other?
Gypsy. You did Gypsy. You did Hello,
Cole
Dolly.
Porter, I'm talking
that
about.
Cole Porter.
Oh, Cole Porter.
Something for the Boys.
Something for the Boys.
That's right.
This lady is a living legend. Okay, Charles. Charles.
Okay.
Anything goes.
Thank you.
Anything goes. Thank you, Ira. Yes, six shows with Cole. All right, now we're ready. All right. Hello, Kathy.
Hi.
Dumb Donald was so dumb. Would you like to know how dumb he was?
Yes.
Okay. He didn't have an air conditioner, Kathy, so to keep cool, he stuck a blank down his pants.
An ice cube?
An ice cube down his pants. That really is dumb.
What's so dumb about that? I would do that.
Well, the dumb part of putting an ice cube, it looked like, you know, you spoiled yourself.
Maybe he wears rubber pants.
It melts. It makes a big mess all over your knees and everything. That's why
I had a really dumb Donald.
What?
He stuck an electric fan
down
his pants.
That's the perfect answer. That's the perfect answer right there.
That's
the perfect answer, yeah.
Dumb Donald has been in the hospital for 6 months because he stuck a fan down his
pants. That's right. Yes.
Well, it's different. Portable fan.
A portable fan, naturally. But Kathy is looking for an ice cube down Dumb Donald's pants. What do you say?
I can't give her an ice cube, but I only give her a fan.
A fan would be dumb because that would hurt a lot. Now, you must match the two remaining celebrities to stay in the game, Kathy. Richard, we're up to you.
Fan.
Fan! So Murray wins again. What'd you have, Joyce? Murray, aren't you getting used to the routine yet? It's the second game you're on. Okay, stand on the tape. Kathy, we've got some gifts for you together with our
thanks. Thank you. It was a lot of fun.
Oh,
thanks,
I'm glad
so
you had
much.
A good time. Kathy Beardsley, ladies and gentlemen, there she goes. And while she's spinning off, we'll send these messages just for you. Here we go. We're ready with Murray Metz, who's been up here now for the second time. He's got $700 to his credit. He's going to try now for over $5,000. Shall we begin?
Yes, please.
We polled a studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Shuffle blank.
Oh.
Now, remember, the answer they gave most frequently is worth $500 if
well,
you match
I had
it.
A terrific
if you match the answer they gave second most often, you get $250. The third gets you $100. Now, let's see who's going to give you some help here.
Avery, please.
Avery.
Shuffleboard.
Shuffleboard is what?
Brett.
What about? Was that one of your songs, Ethel? Shuffle off to Buffalo?
No, that was before my time.
What's the matter with you?
Shuffle off to Buffalo.
And Charles, please.
Charles.
I heard him. Shuffle along.
Shuffle along. The audience is not too thrilled with that, but third position is tough. Remember that. Now, when you're trying to come up with an answer, you got shuffle along, shuffle off to Buffalo, and shuffleboard. You can choose one of those or give us one of your own. It's entirely up to you.
I like shuffleboard.
You like shuffleboard. Okay. John, do the audience have another answer?
No.
No.
90% shuffleboard.
Most of them say shuffleboard. All right. Well, Murray,
choice.
We hope it's up there, and let's find out if it is up there right now. We'll begin down at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Shuffle along. Charles gave you that answer. Another triumphant answer from Charles. Shuffleboard is what we're after. Let's see if it's under the $250 number. Shuffle off to Buffalo. You got two out of the three the celebrities have given you so far. So that's a good omen, Murray. And here we go with the $500 number. Slide it, Earl.
Got it.
Double ball. Congratulations. There you go. How is it when two guys with mustaches kiss?
A lot of electricity.
A lot of electricity. Terrific. Okay, now, listen, you got a total of $1,200, and you're going to play for 10 times the amount you just won, or $5,000, but you've got to match one celebrity exactly.
I'm going to go with Richard again.
Going to go with Richard again. All right, you're going to try him again. All right, swing around and face me. I will get the $5,000 question. It is in my hand. And I can't get it out of the envelope.
But
there
you
it
will.
Is.
And you did.
Reads as follows. Dean blank. That's D-E-A-N blank. Now, he's finished, Murray. What answer comes to your mind to match his? Get your ESP going over to him. And think of the answer that he wrote down. And say it, and we'll see if it matches. Dean blank.
Dean Martin.
Dean Martin. The audience is with you. All right. Richard, he says, that'll do it for $5,000, but it's up to you to tell us. What do you say?
Well, there are a lot. Dean Jones and Dean and Jerry.
Yes.
And everybody loves...
Okay, Murray, good for you. Now, if you're ready, Murray, we'll just plow on. Can we do that?
Please.
All right. Murray says, let's just plow on here and meet Kay Denny. Welcome, Kay Denny. Hi there. Okay, we can get on now.
Thank you.
You're very happy for him, are you, Kay?
Yes, I am, but I'm ready to beat him.
You're ready to beat him? That's the attitude. You got to get in there and slug. Let's find out a little bit about you before we start the game.
Okay, I'm from Dallas, Texas. Great state. I live in Los Angeles right now. I've lived here for 9 months, and my husband goes to school out here. We're probably going to move back in a couple of years.
You're going back to Texas in a couple of years
of
when he finishes school.
Mm-hmm.
What's he studying?
He's studying the Bible.
He's studying the Bible?
Yes. Yeah.
Well, there's a lot there. Good luck to you, Kay Denny. We'll start
Thank
this
you.
Game in a moment or so, but right now, this message for you. Here we go. You're all ready. We've introduced Kay Denny, and we'll begin with round one. Kay, it's your choice.
I'll take B.
B it is. New game, folks. The nurse said... The doctors in the hospital are strange. They don't wear rubber gloves, they wear rubber blanks. Strange doctors.
In the hospital.
I've never put my faith in doctors.
Yes.
You have to be careful.
They don't wear rubber gloves, they wear rubber blanks.
I got it.
Charles is ready. Do not hesitate.
Do not hesitate.
He who hesitates is lost. That's okay. Yeah, that's it.
There are two.
That's it. Very good.
Okay.
Please.
Right.
Perfect.
Okay. Put it in the slot, and we go to Kay Denny. The nurse said the doctors in this hospital are strange. They don't wear rubber gloves, they wear rubber blanks.
Panties.
Well, Kay, really, my dear. You know, I'm sitting here thinking, well, all of the rubber things, but the last thing, well, anyway, it's just never crossed my mind. I don't know. Avery, what'd you say? Avery, the machine, put the nickel in
Avery. Cubes.
You're still thinking of ice cubes.
I, gee, that's perfect. I didn't have that. I had rubber socks.
Rubber socks. There they are. See, he's wearing them. What'd you say?
Well, you know what? All the little doctors are so young now, they've never been potty trained.
Oh, I see. So that's
why... So they wear their little rubber panties.
Oh, yeah. Really surprised the heck out of me. Surprise the heck out of me, child.
I don't understand.
I did it without the joke before. Just rubber panties.
Candy. Surprise the heck out of me, Kay. Oh. Ethel? Doctors in the hospital are strange. They don't wear rubber gloves. They wear rubber blanks.
Oh, gee, I don't know. They were real strange. They wear rubber hands.
Rubber hands. What a romantic thought.
Yes.
Yes, Richard.
It was strange.
Yeah, weird.
Well, I thought they were strange. They wore rubber ducks.
Rubber ducks.
Yes. Oh, dear.
They look kind of...
Now, speaking of weirdos and strangos, where do you get a load of this answer, folks?
I would hate to go to that hospital, is all I can say. I said rubber galoshes.
Galoshes. But, you know, she did score two matches with that, because I was thinking of galoshes, you know, and rubber booties and all of the things, but, well, anyway, all right. Now, Murray, this is your first round question, and it goes as follows. Mildred said, I don't like to gossip, but...
Yeah.
Let me tell you about that new secretary. The only time she knows what she's doing is when she's in the blank. To gossip. Let me tell you about that new secretary. The only time she knows what she's doing is when she's in the blank. Right, right. Yeah,
that's a good one.
Yeah, oh, yeah, of course. Yeah.
Wait a minute.
No. Right, that's
okay.
Terrific.
Is that nice? Did you like that? Huh?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, sure. Anything. Just get on with it.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Charles ready over there? He's writing another play.
No.
We'll wait, Charles.
Going to sleep first.
We're running out of music, Charles.
I'm ready. Thank you.
Mildred said, I don't like to gossip, but let me tell you about that new secretary. The only time she knows what she's doing is when she's in the bed. Okay. Avery, what'd you say?
Murray, where are you?
Murray.
Well, the only time this secretary knows what she's doing is when she's in the toilet.
Yeah, all right. There's one. Brett.
I think the definitive answer, and this may be a match. There may be a little argument and a lot of rioting, but
just
when she's in the boss's office.
No match, but that's a good answer.
Thank you, dear.
Charles?
I'll take it a step further. The doctor said I would lose my... The boss's apartment.
The boss's apartment. No match yet, Murray. Let's see what Ethel Merman has. The only time she knows what she's doing is when she's in the blank.
Well, I went a little further than Brett. I said in the boss's lap.
Boss's lap is a good answer. Very good answer.
I said the toity.
In the toity. Boss's
Rappaport-y are the two good ones. Not that I expect you to have it, but show us anyway.
It's just that Ethel was a secretary and
that's
she
right.
knows.
That's right.
Why I wrote Boston.
Oh, were you really?
Oh, sure.
No kidding. So there you are at the end of round one, 2-0 in favor of the challenger, and round two is yet to come, but not now. First dish.
Well, listen, you've made the time go by very quickly with your wit and enthusiasm
song,
and terrificness, and I thank you very much, and I shall look forward to seeing all of you. But what is their date again? June?
The 26th of June,
June
Chicago.
June 26th, yes. Chicago.
Who's coming next?
Listen, next time we get together, these are the Kooky Lookies who will be on this stage.
The Kooky?
Dick Gaudier, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Marianne Mobley, Richard Dawson.
Team Neighbor News, join us next time. That's Game 76. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 76. Amar Goodson, Bill Cochran production. Stay tuned for Tattle Tales next over most of these CBS stations. We'll be right back.